Good afternoon, everyone. TSB Television proudly presents High School Boys Basketball. Today, our final game of the 2010-2011 regular season, and it's going to be a dandy with the Twin Cities Boys Championship. The Minneapolis Washburn Millers host the Johnson Governors in a fight between the last two champions in Class 3A. Our title Titans will meet up momentarily. Welcome, everyone. I'm Mike Peden, and I'd like to thank all of you who stuck with us through the 2010-2011 season, our first year with GrantStadium.tv. And we'd like to thank Grant Stadium for providing all their services, bandwidth, and resources that allowed us to bring our games to our new online home. It's a shame our season has to come to an end today, but we're going out with a fine style. You couldn't ask for a better matchup than Washburn and Johnson, the last two state champions for Class 3A. And it's a possible state tournament preview. Both schools are in different sections. Washburn and Johnson bring similar styles on the court. Both use a lot of players. They have no superstars. They don't have any favorites per se. Some players score more than others, but it's simply a matter of how the game flows. For Washburn, four of their starting five average double figures, and it all starts with their point guard play. Nick Anderson, a sophomore, but Reggie Perkins, the head coach of the Millers, told me he's developed a lot. He's a high IQ, and that creates a lot of openings and a lot of opportunities for the Washburn offense. Johnson is geared by Eston Tyler, the leading scorer in the St. Paul City Conference. He has already signed a scholarship to the University of Missouri in Kansas City. It's a Division I mid-major in the Summit League, but just because it's a mid-major doesn't mean those players aren't any good. Johnson will use every one of their players before the first half comes to an end. So if you want to beat Johnson, you have to be ready to handle their depth. And on that note, here are the keys to the game. For Johnson, it's defense. That's been their mantra for the last few years, and that's why they have not lost to a Minnesota team in almost 2 years. Their two losses this year were to non-conference schools outside the state. Milwaukee King from Wisconsin and Hyde Park in Illinois. Neither will have an effect on section or state tournament seeding. Sharing the ball, that's something that is not an issue for Johnson. And finally, attacking with depth, as I mentioned. Very deep team. They'll play everybody. If you're on Johnson's roster, you're not going to sit on the bench. Washburn, ball control. Johnson, a team that likes to score off transition, so limiting turnovers will be key. Getting the rebounds. Johnson has a great rebounder in Chris Smith Bond, and he's also a great inside threat. So you've got to beat him to win that battle. And shot selection. Johnson's not going to give you a lot of open looks. They're going to make you fight for every shot, so you have to make those shots count. Our starting lineups are coming up next. You're watching high school basketball on TSB Television. Stick around as we conclude the 2010-2011 season. Time for the starting lineups. St. Paul Johnson will go first. Their starters are Anthony Lee, number one at guard. Eston Tyler, number three at guard. Number 24, Roosevelt Scott at guard. Number 23, Marcus Marshall at guard. And number 55 at center, Chris Smith Bond. Eston Tyler done great things for the Governors this season, last season, pretty much every year he's played. Headed to Missouri, Kansas City, leading the St. Paul City Conference at 17.8 points per game. For Washburn, it's Dwight Anderson, number 10 at guard. Nick Anderson, number 11 at guard. Miles Shepard Anderson, number 24 at forward. Clarence Thomas, number 25 at guard. And Cedric Chappelle, number 45 at forward. Clarence Thomas, the leading scorer for Washburn, not far behind Tyler in terms of points per game, even though he's just sixth in the Minneapolis City scoring race. We'd like to remind you, if you want to get a DVD copy of this game, just click the purchase DVD link at the top of the page. And we once again want to thank GrandStadium.tv for their support throughout the 2010-2011 season. We had a lot of fun joining them in our first year with Grand Stadium as they continue to expand their high school coverage. Don't go too far. They will have the high school boys and girls quarterfinals in a few weeks. And then we move to the spring tournaments. St. Paul Johnson and Washburn, as we mentioned in the open, the last two 3A state champions. Johnson has an undefeated record against Minnesota teams going back to the last 55 games. They have not lost to a Minnesota team in almost 2 years. Their two losses against Hyde Park in Illinois and King over in Milwaukee, they said were eye-openers, as we have Smith Bond and Chappelle for the tip. Roosevelt Scott wasting no time. If you follow boys basketball, you know they are going to move very fast. That's Dwight Anderson, team's second leading scorer, seventh in the Minneapolis City Conference in scoring. 16.1 points per game. Both schools run similar offense, similar defense. They're going to use a lot of kids as this game goes on. Roosevelt Scott, too strong on the drive. Johnson ball. Johnson and head coach Vern Simmons never get to the big head about any game. They don't have any giant egos to worry about. It's always one game at a time. Tyler missed a three, but Scott's there for their offensive board. Kicks out. This is Lee, but he's too strong. And picked up by Thomas, and he's in trouble. Out to Miles Shepard Anderson, now to Nick Anderson. No good. That was Dwight Anderson, I should say, but with the cleanup is Chappelle, I believe. It's 4-2, Washburn over Johnson. Smith Bond out to Lee, and one. Smith Bond, a much improved player. They say he's more of an inside threat this year than last year. Last year, simply a rebounding specialist. This year, he can dish out and get assists. Anthony Lee at the line. Can't complete the three-point play. He gets 9.3 a game. Three of the top four spots over the back ball in Washburn. Three of the four top spots in the St. Paul City Conference scoring rates are held by Johnson players. Tyler Scott and Marcus Marshall. And the number 2 through 6 positions are separated by 7/10 of a point. So it's a very tight race in the St. Paul City Conference for that scoring title. But for these guys, it's simply a stat. Thomas is blocked. But Chappelle's there to pick it up. In the game, that's Nick Anderson, number 11. Going to Chappelle, and Chappelle muscles his way for the basket. Jump ball, possession arrow, favors Washburn. Johnson's two losses, as we mentioned, real eye-opener. Reminded everybody that just because you went undefeated last year doesn't mean you're going to steamroll through all your games. And again, they don't get cocky, but I spoke with Colin Moore. They kind of went away from their style of ball. That's a foul. It's going to go against Shelby Ashford of Johnson. He's in the game now, 6'5", junior forward. After those two losses, they refocused, got back on track. And with a program like the Governor's, that's not long, not hard. Anderson with his first. Washburn, last year, had to rebuild with a senior heavy team that won the 09 3A state championship. And Reggie Birkin says they have rebuilt and are ready to go in 2011. Washburn up 8-4. We're not used to seeing Johnson trail. Last year's Twin Cities game, they steamrolled Minneapolis North. North finished one game back this year in the Minneapolis City Conference standings. Two games back, I should say. Roosevelt Scott with the steal. Eston Tyler cannot finish. And Lee is stripped. Dwight Anderson picks it up. Look out, ref. For three. That was Thomas, no good. But Shepard Anderson with the rebound. He's short. Over the back, no good from Chappelle. And another offensive board. Still doesn't go in. Another, and one. What presence on the offensive side of the glass for Washburn. Cedric Chappelle finally cleans it up for the Millers. Chappelle, one of four Washburn players averaging double figures this season. 12.5 points per game. We haven't seen Johnson struggle this much in a long time, at least out of the opening gate. No three-point play, but Johnson on their heels, down by six. Scott loses the handle. Chappelle's steal, but Scott steals it right back, and they cancel each other out. Tyler, alley-oop, no good. Scott, or Ashford, couldn't bring it in. Dwight Anderson, too strong. No cleanup. And then Marcel West with the board for Johnson, but Tyler can't finish. He has struggled early. And another foul on Johnson. Ashford already has two. And now our first substitution for Washburn, number 22, Jerry Pratt. Pratt going for it, and he's going to the line. Johnson racking up fouls early. West picked up a foul, now Lee picks up a foul. Pratt missed the front end. Just 4.3 points per game this season. Doesn't see a lot of action on the score column, but he will see some playing time. Gets on the board here. Washburn building an 11-4 lead. Johnson has yet to lead. Don't tell these schools this is a regular season game that will have no implications on the playoffs. They're certainly not playing like it. Lee gets his own rebound. Kicks out, and the blocking foul is called. That's Waylon Johnson, who will now go to the line. Again, Johnson will use all of their varsity players before the first half comes to an end. That's just their style of ball. Waylon Johnson, 6.2 points per game this season. Quashingham Smith now in for the Governors. 11-6, our score. Nick to Pratt. Lee with the steal. Here comes the transition. And Washburn picks up the rebound after a failed attempt from Johnson. Andy Layton was there for three. Thomas too strong. Johnson just not establishing the transition game, as Wes couldn't find Smith. And the Millers to inbound. Another player in, that's Javon Smith for the Millers, number 32. Nick Anderson couldn't find Pratt. And here comes Johnson. Finally a finish. The transition game has been their weak spot. West missed it. Johnson was there for the cleanup. Now Johnson cuts the lead to three. Dwight Anderson with the basket for the Millers, and we're going to have a timeout with 12:41 to go in the first, and I'll have a chance to catch up on some of these names. Again, both schools not afraid to use their entire roster. All I have to say, it's a shame I'm calling this game solo. Just couldn't work out some things. I thought I'd have a couple partners here. One got sick, another not able to contact, and what a shame it is to not have a partner with this game simply because of the crowd that's come here, the aura, the atmosphere. I spoke with Reggie Perkins before the game and Colin Moore, both from Washburn and Johnson, respectively. And he said having the last two 3A state champions meet is just a testament of the strength these two schools and the cities of St. Paul and Minneapolis have in the sport of basketball. Johnson finally winning a state title after many years of getting to the big dance in 2010. Washburn has won two state titles. They won in 1994 in the old two-class format. And of course, 15 years later, they picked one up in 3A. And despite Washburn's status in 1994, none of their players were selected to attend the All-Star game, as we have a steal from Quashingham Smith. And he loses it to Dwight Anderson. Now it's Nick Anderson with the runner. Lee back in for the Governors, as is Scott, as Tyler. Washburn could not get the steal in time. 11:38 in half number one. With a near capacity crowd watching a battle basically for breaking rights. A fun one though. Tyler, the younger brother of Essence Tyler, who participated in the Johnson girls basketball team for several years. Johnson girls, though, just not able to find the success the boys program has had. Anthony Lee with the runner. And And that's his first field goal. It's 15-10. Thomas is thinking about it, but kicks out. Open! Kyle Hughes now in the game for the Millers. Thomas drives. What a beautiful play by Clarence Thomas. Johnson not wasting any time. Roosevelt Scott is short, and a foul on Washingham Smith. And more substitutions in the Johnson carousel. Now we see number four, his name not appearing on the program, so we will get a name for you during the halftime break. We can't tell you Marshall's back in. Scott with the steal, looking for Tyler. Tyler is blocked, but a foul is called. No block will be awarded to Javon Smith. He made contact, according to the officials. Chappelle now back in the game for the Millers. Tyler at the line. And another foul is called. This time it's on Roosevelt Scott, pleading his case to the official, but to no avail. Washburn, home to a couple of my colleagues, Tony Gear, who is not with us today. He is running the wrestling tournament on Grand Stadium. And Onika Craven, who's interning at the Spokesman Recorder. Kind of a jack of all trades, if you will. Thomas with the first three-pointer of the game. Johnson ball. Marshall will inbound it with 9 minutes and 55 seconds left in the first half. 19-12 is our score. Washburn over Johnson. Washburn named for the milling industry that was prominent here in the last century. And prominent there is Waylon Johnson. He's getting involved on the offense. 6 points unofficially. A block. Keith Crenshaw was blocked, but Hughes is there. Here comes Shepard Anderson, and he doesn't get the basket, but as Johnson blocks it away. Keith Crenshaw, number five, in for the Millers. And now Hughes will step out. Nick Anderson back in. Thomas from the corner. Bullseye. Johnson gets the answer. Marcus Marshall. Nick Anderson can't do it. And Chappelle is blocked, but Anderson Shepard gets another offensive board and will go to the line as Johnson is now in the penalty. Foul on Johnson. Waylon Johnson, that is. Miles Anderson Shepherd will shoot two. Shepherd Anderson, that is. There's a lot of Andersons on the Washburn team, making things a little difficult to follow. Miles doesn't get a whole lot of scoring, just 4.3 a game. Breaks through there, though. Tyler, NBA, not good. Crenshaw wanted it, but Tyler with the steal. Johnson just not finding their targets on the alley-oop. But Roosevelt Scott wrestles for every last inch, and now he'll go to the line. Although I didn't see a shooting motion. They're calling it a shooting foul. It didn't look that way, but when you get close to the rim, with the bang-bang plays you see in Boyd's basketball, it's difficult for the guys in the stripes. I know I wouldn't want to be down there. So here's Roosevelt Scott, who's made a big improvement academically since his freshman year. And as I've been told by the Johnson coaching staff, he basically could write a check, or the school could write a check for him, to any Division I junior college that he wanted to go to. Dwight Anderson back in for the Millers. Jerry Pratt returning for Washburn. Roosevelt Scott makes both. Johnson has been as close as three this half. They have yet to lead. Outside of the opening tip, of course. For three. Not this time from Thomas. Pratt fighting for the rebound. Thomas has it again, but he can't hang on. Johnson calls the timeout just in the nick of time. 8:04 remaining in half number one. As we mentioned, both schools in different sections, so a state tournament matchup is not out of the question. Some even have Washburn favored to win their section. A lot of folks will expect Johnson to punch another ticket to the state tournament. But you got to get through section play first. And Johnson, throughout their program history with head coach Vern Simmons, never a team that looks ahead. They always look forward, never ahead. Vern Simmons, a very calm, collected fellow. Works as a school police officer over at Johnson. He did for a while. He still does some security for other events. But to him, each game is just that, another game. Tyler finally finding his shot. And he draws a foul, but it was before the shot. Johnson, now a 2-point margin. Smith Bomb, we haven't seen much out of him. For three, Marcus Marshall from the corner. Marshall with the second tray. Johnson takes their first lead of the game, and this is the Governor's team we're expecting to see. Smith Bomb with the rebound after Dwight Anderson couldn't respond. Marshall out to Wesley Johnson. No good. Smith Bomb with the rebound and the foul. As we mentioned, Smith Bomb, primarily a rebounder last year. Coaches told me they would put him in the starting lineups to win the opening tip, and then he'd go right to the bench. Not this year. He's taken much more leadership in his abilities, in his team. Getting several looks at Division III colleges. And now he's on the board with two. Nick to Dwight. Dwight, charge. Now Washburn out of fouls to give. And we're seeing the Johnson team, so many fans have come to expect now that they're settled in. Tyler for three. Can't do it. Clarence Thomas with the rebound, finds an open Pratt. And Roosevelt Scott will be tagged for the foul. Scott with two personal. Pratt, 4.3 points per game coming into this contest. Has 1 point unofficially. Gets the back end. Lead to Tyler. Johnson slowing things down now. Now Lee in a double team, gets out of it. And Tyler will reset things for the Governors. Marshall drained a couple threes. But Johnson won't attack until they find a shot they like. Marshall likes his, but he's short. Thomas with the rebound. Nick Anderson to bring it up. Thomas thought about a three. Drives inside, kicks out. And the finish from Chappelle. Chappelle with his first field goal of the game. His second, I should say, missed a three-point play. Marshall can't finish. Thomas with the board. Nick Anderson with Tyler guarding him. Goes to Dwight Anderson. Anderson off the screen, and another charge is called. That wipes away what would have been a lead grabbing basket for the Millers. Dwight Anderson now has two. Foul trouble really not going to be a problem for either team because they're so deep. You take one off the floor, they'll reload with someone else. Less than 5 minutes now in the first. Tyler for two. No good. That was Ashford with the rebound. Tyler will try again, and he traveled. Jalen Albritton in the game for the Governors, as they have now used 10 players. Washburn has used 9 so far, as Miles Shepherd Anderson is back in, and he wastes no time making use of his time on the floor. That's his first field goal. And now Washburn retakes the lead, 28-26. Washburn now running the zone. Johnson can run out as much clock as they like with no shot clock. Tyler going to Scott, top of the key, but he's short. Rebound, Shepard Anderson. Nick Anderson kicks out again. A beautiful dish, and Chappelle with the basket. Chappelle with six, unofficially. Ashford inside to Scott. And now Johnson getting those short range shots to fall. A lot of high flying action, very fast paced as boys basketball in the city always is. Heck, throughout the state, it's not a surprise to see teams to run the floor virtually every play. We'll have first half stats and analysis for you following the halftime break. And we'll preview what's to come with our state tournament coverage. TSB Television itself will not be there because of the contract with Grand Stadium and KSTC Channel 45, but I personally will call the 3A girls quarterfinals and the 4A boys quarterfinals in the next few weeks, as well as the boys third place games, which I'm not a fan of particularly, but I'm not affiliated with the high school league. Shepard Anderson missed the 14 footer. Not a fan of third place games, not simply because one school will lose twice in the state tournament in each class, but the emotional investment every team makes when you get to state, when you get to that level, is so huge that to come back and play another game for a consolation prize is very difficult. As you don't remember who won third place, you only remember who won. For that matter, you don't remember who finished second either. Lee, bounce pass. No good. We're still trying to get a name on number four. Johnson ball. Johnson has now used 11 players, their full allotment on the varsity roster today. Just about anyway. I see that one player has not undressed to take the court. But if you're on Johnson's team, you better be ready to play so you can't take a day off, period. 2:28 in half number one. Johnson slowing things up a bit. Lee catches Washburn falling asleep. We're not used to seeing Johnson halt things on offense with their preference to drive. Thomas for three. He's been off as of late. Shepard Anderson got the rebound but couldn't make much use out of it as Chappelle couldn't bring in the pass. We're knotted up at 30. Johnson could theoretically hold for the final shot, but they're not going to do that. I'd be willing to put money on that. Eston Tyler with the backdoor layup. He's been quiet, and you have to think Washburn's keeping an eye on him. Chappelle is blocked. It's Johnson ball. Waylon Johnson with the block, and he got it off Chappelle. Tough to see from this angle, but the officials have the better vantage point, and they rule it not the ball. Johnson in the east side of St. Paul in the Payne Arcade area. Anthony Lee, what a layup. I didn't see it from here. But Johnson got the ball back. Nick Anderson was called for the push. And because Washburn is in the penalty following this timeout, Johnson will shoot free throws. It's 34-30, Johnson over Washburn. Johnson hasn't steamrolled opponents like they did last year. They had a close contest with Richfield a couple weeks ago, a 97-82 win, in part because they didn't play a smart first half, at least in the eyes of the coaches. But the first half, always the appetizer, especially if you're on Johnson's team. They were trailing big to Minnesota Transitions a few weeks ago in a game over at Johnson. And then the Governors used a 64-point second half to win 104-90. I don't think we're going to break triple digits today, but Johnson has that capability. And a lot of people speculated, had it not been for the TV timeouts that KSDC Channel 45 implements in their broadcasts, Johnson would have ran away. Lee went down, missed the front end of the 1-1. Nick Anderson finds Miles Shepard Anderson. Thomas in trouble. Uh-oh, Marcus Marshall by himself, and he's fouled before he can slam it home. We've seen a few players dunk in warm-ups earlier this afternoon. We have yet to see a slam dunk here. I'm sure that would wow the crowd, but we're not here for that. If you're Washburn, this is all you can do. A few Gopher women are in attendance now. I see Kiara Buford, China Antoine, and Kristen Dockery. Marcus Marshall made both free throws. Golden Gopher women's team, a rather forgettable season this year as they struggle to find offensive production. No traveling call. Chappelle inside. Look out, Bob Miller. Javon Smith back in for the Millers with 22 seconds. They do not use tenths of a second here at Washburn with their scoreboard. They don't stop the clock for made baskets anyway. Javon Smith with the runner. Gets on the board. Johnson with time, 13 seconds. That was close to an over the back call, over and back I should say, but no backcourt violation ruled. 5 seconds. I don't think Johnson realizes they're running out of time. Marshall does, but he can't get the runner to end the first half, but still, Johnson getting things together after a slow start. They head to the locker room with the 36-32 lead. We'll take a break, calculate our numbers, and come back with first half stats and analysis. You're watching high school basketball on TSB television. Welcome back to the second half of high school boys basketball. I'm Mike Peden, bringing you the Twin Cities Boys Championship between Washburn and Johnson. Leading scorers, no one with 10 points yet. Anthony Lee, Marcus Marshall, and Waylon Johnson all have 8 for the Governors. Eston Tyler with 6. Roosevelt Scott with 4. Washburn, Clarence Thomas with 9. Cedric Chappelle with 8. Dwight Anderson with 6. Shepard Anderson with 3. Javon Smith with 2. But a very balanced attack. And so we're just not a lot of scoring, no stars, but that's been the motto of both teams all season. Marshall missed the 3. Smith Bond with the rebound, and he's fouled. Not the way Washburn wanted to start half number 2. They're wearing the black jerseys. Johnson wearing the white jerseys. I spoke with a few of the Gopher women's players that attended. Kiara Buford, China Antoine, and Kristen Dockery. They're back, of course, because they got knocked out in the first round of the Big Ten tournament. But if you talk to them, you never would have known it. And I discovered that I got a tweet earlier this morning as they were trying to find the location of the game. And Kiara was asking me, where's the sports brain when you need him? That is my Twitter username. But they found it without me. I've joked that Kiara just might put me out of a job. She's a communications major, and a lot of folks believe she could handle the role of television reporter for basketball. Miles Shepard Anderson missed. Chappelle with the cleanup. Our first double-digit score. Here comes Roosevelt Scott. What a beauty. Washburn trying to go the other way. A little too fast. But you can live with aggressive turnovers. Sloppy turnovers, that's another story. Shepard Anderson going for the steal. Can't quite do it. Anthony Lee, back to Scott. Johnson has so many players that can have big games. Lee, he's on the line. That's good for 2. And he becomes Johnson's first double-digit scorer. Chappelle was left open. Anthony Lee says, get out of here. Chappelle shook his defender, Anthony Lee. He saw it, comes racing to Chappelle's position and gets the block. Johnson always alert. They never sleep. They're up 42-34. Anderson, or that's Thomas, he can't get the 15-footer, and it's rebounded by Lee. Scramble, and a jump ball. Possession goes back to Washburn. Dwight is fouled. More free throws coming for Dwight Anderson. Johnson, 10 of 12 from the charity stripe in the first half. Washburn, 5 of 9. And that has played out into our score so far. Dwight Anderson, 7th in the Minneapolis City Conference in scoring, with 16.1 per game. And now the fouling will start to rack up as Shelby Asher picks up his 3rd, but again, Johnson has used all 11 of their players. As Dwight Anderson misses the back end, Tyler double teamed, looking for help. Roosevelt Scott open, can't finish. Chappelle rings in the rebound. Dwight Anderson, 13-footer, no good. And Johnson picks it up. Tyler gets to the double team and draws the moving foul on Thomas. We might be here a while. Johnson ball, 15:48 to go. Washburn now going to the man as they try to cut that Johnson lead, and a foul on Johnson as Chappelle picked up the steal. This one will be on Lee. And you have to think both schools will be front runners to make a state tournament appearance. Just the way they played, very even, similar styles. In fact, Reggie Perkins told me he models his Washburn team from Johnson's team. Vern Simmons has been around a long time, taking his team to many state tournament appearances in 4A and 3A. And Johnson, they've done so well because they always buy into a system. The team chemistry always improves from the start of the season to the end. You never will see anybody on Johnson complaining about how many minutes or how many points he has, because they know it's all about the state championship, and they've already put the 2010 championship behind them. Dwight Anderson missed the three. Johnson can't get it. Dwight Anderson will get free throws. For Washburn, it's all about rebuilding that program. One of their assistant athletic directors, Giovanni Jenkins, is here. He was a member of that 1994 Class 2A tournament team that won Washburn's first state title in basketball. Dwight Anderson is only getting ones and not twos. Thomas feeling it. Not this time. Tyler with the rebound. Here he comes, coast to coast. No finish, but free throws coming. Tyler with just 6 points. But in Johnson's system, he can live with that. He's good enough where he is going to Missouri, Kansas City, a D1 mid-major Summit League member. So he will not compete against a former governor, but he will be in the same conference as one, Freddie Coleman, who attended North Dakota State upon his graduation. He made an NCAA tournament appearance, of course, and actually got to play at his home when the Metrodome hosted the first two rounds a couple years ago. Tyler quietly has 8 points. Of course, with Tyler, he's never quiet. Chappelle with an over-the-back layup. Chappelle winning in style points, I'll say that much. 6-point margin. Washburn won the ninth grade battle between these two teams. Johnson won the JV game, so this is in effect a rubber match. Waylon Johnson with the assist from Smith Bond. Johnson off the bench has 10 points. He averages 6.2. It's a rubber match if you want to go that way. But everybody comes for the varsity game. Freshmen and JV aren't included in the state tournament, but you can use those players in your varsity roster if you want to. Thomas hasn't found his stroke as of late, but Dwight Anderson is there to put it in. Roosevelt Scott shakes his defender. Can't do it. Rebound Chappelle. Nick Anderson. Free throws coming. Fouls are starting to pile up with 13:28 remaining in half number two. Smith Bond picks up his second personal. Nick Anderson with the front end. He averages 7.8 points per game. And Reggie Perkins told me is the catalyst for Washburn's offense. A young point guard, but getting smarter every game. They believe it's all about having power in numbers, but they're just not getting the free throws to fall. Waylon Johnson stepped on the line, and Washburn's double team pays off with a turnover. Thomas is blocked, and it goes in. Waylon Johnson partially altered that shot, and that works out to Thomas's benefit. Thomas with 12, and a steal. It's Brad. Brad going for it, and we're tied with 13:01. Brad's first field goal, and it couldn't come at a bigger time. Again, nothing on the line in terms of playoff brackets, but breaking rights and momentum. Again, these two schools aren't going to treat this game as if there's nothing on the line. Marshall for three. He's short. And it will stay with Johnson as Chappelle couldn't bring in the board. Lee will inbound it. And Marshall can't finish. And a foul on Brad as he grabbed the jersey. You can't do that, whether it's football, whether it's basketball. You grab the jersey, you'll get called for the holding foul. The foul is Pratt's second. And now we are going the other way. And with Thomas, I didn't see it because I was updating my stats, but Roosevelt Scott with a quick give and go. Chance for an and one. Can't do it. So Roosevelt Scott has 8 points, and I'm sure you'll see it on the replay if you haven't already. Thomas for three. Got it. Washburn takes a 1 point lead, and we have a stoppage in play with the clock is still going. The clock is going. Fans are yelling, reset the clock. They stop it with 11:59. The clock was running. A few seconds ticked off. And they're gonna let that go, but a few seconds ticked off. I think about 8 seconds went off the clock before they stopped it. Dwight Anderson with the steal. Nope, goaltending is called. They call the goaltend. They call the goaltend. That was clear as crystal, and give credit to the baseline official for spotting that. That is a layup wiped away because of the goaltend. Washburn player touched the rim as the ball was going to the rim. You can't do that, of course. If the ball is heading towards the basket, you cannot touch it. This game is getting wilder as the minutes tick. Marcus Marshall, no foul. And Thomas with the steal. Washburn had numbers, but Thomas couldn't find Dwight Anderson. I hope you're having fun watching this. We're having a ball. Johnson can't handle it. And Washburn will take possession. One thing's for sure, you won't have to worry about 10-second violations. Dwight Anderson finds Pratt, but he was off balance. Marshall picks it up. He's struggled as of late. He's in trouble. Breaks from the double team, finding Tyler, and Tyler is stripped. Johnson with their toughest challenge yet. Thomas out of control. Johnson with numbers. Waylon Johnson draws a foul. They give him the basket. Foul is on Anderson. We're going to have a timeout with 10:34 to go. Foul is Anderson's third. 50-49, Johnson over Washburn. I don't think anyone told these schools that no playoffs brackets, no one and done here is on the line. The way they're playing, it feels like a state tournament final, but of course the state tournament is held at a much bigger venue, Target Center. Johnson's last basket gave them 12, but he misses the three-point play. And Thomas with the rebound. Nick Anderson. Kicks out to Dwight. After using up the dribble, now back to Nick. Washburn showing a little patience now. Nick Anderson, and one. Nick Anderson didn't get a lot of action in the first half, starting to find some scoring here as we have substitutions on both sides. Tyler going back in. Quashingham Smith. Marshall staying in. Miles Shepherd Anderson back in. Nick Anderson uses every inch of the rim to put it in. 10 minutes to go in an exciting Twin Cities Boys Championship. Johnson with a huge challenge. They've been battle-tested this year. Last year, they steamrolled Minneapolis North to win the Twin Cities Championship, and then, of course, they won state over Grand Rapids. But if it wasn't for those media timeouts, a lot of folks thought they would have steamrolled Grand Rapids as well. Quashingham Smith with the steal. Scott with the pull-up. Scott becomes the third Johnson player to get double figures, and we're tied at 52, but not for long. Chappelle with 14. Scott from the corner, but he's short. Washington Smith saves it, and Pratt says, not in my house. Could you imagine the fireworks if these two meet again in state tournament play? And I wouldn't be there to call it. KSDC, of course, has Dave Lee handling those duties, so I am not needed. Quite frankly, I don't think I'm ready for that level yet. Look at that, Tyler using himself as a decoy and getting Waylon Johnson another basket. That gives him 14. Washburn is ready, and Miles Shepard-Anderson draws the foul. That is Johnson's last to give. 54 all, 8:57 to go. We're gonna have free throws for the remainder of this game. It's a good thing we brought a lot of tape, as we might be here for a while. Overtime, not out of the question. Anderson going to Chappelle. Back out to Nick Anderson. Washburn resetting. Miles Shepard-Anderson, too strong. Tyler picks it up. Two on two. Tyler gets through Johnson, but he has no one to go to. And now Washburn bringing it the other way. Nick Anderson is fouled by Lee. And Johnson in the penalty. So one and one coming for Nick Anderson, the 5'10 sophomore guard. I'll say this, if you're a coach in training, or a younger player waiting to play varsity ball, this is a perfect example of how you balance your offense. If you look at this score sheet, even though Washburn needs to work on their free throws, no one player is doing all the work. Tyler with another assist, and this time it's West with his first field goal. We know Tyler can put up a lot of points, but he's no selfish player. It's 56-55. Johnson with the lead back. Pratt lost the ball. It will stay with Johnson. We got two players on top of each other, Chappelle and Wesley Waylon Johnson. They're having a laugh about it as they're waiting for the call. We see Eston Tyler getting involved in all aspects of the game. That's why he's going to play Division I ball next year. Scott, no good. Javon Smith with the rebound. Driving right, tough shot. But Pratt is there to clean things up. Pratt with six. Seven and a half. In an epic final game of the regular season for both teams. Our final regular season game. Thomas with the steal. And he draws a foul. That's on Marshall, his second. Lee picked up his third. Fouls piling up, but again, both teams are so deep that they can afford a foul or two. And here come more substitutions. Smith Bond coming in. Jalen Albritton coming in. And Quashingham Smith, all for the Governors. Thomas missed both, and we're going Johnson's way. For Washburn to have a decent chance of getting to the state tournament, they have to make those free throws count. They have not done so today. 7:06. Pratt gets the steal after Albritton missed. And this time, Javon Smith makes the count for the Millers. Tyler for three. No good. It's staying Johnson's ball. As Marcel West took a climb up the stairs. There's a staircase where he is. Doesn't open up to anything. At least at this time of day. Tyler to Quashingham Smith. No good. It's picked off. Dwight Anderson. And once again, Chappelle gives Washburn a 5-point lead. Roosevelt Scott. No good. Washburn has not led by more than 5 in this half. Dwight Anderson is short. Rebound. Anderson thought about it. Cedric Chappelle, by the way, has 16 points. And the Miller fans in attendance are cheering on their 2009 Class 3A state champions. And as the minutes wind down, Chappelle again! A phenomenal game for Cedric Chappelle. As the minutes wind down, Johnson's streak against Minnesota teams is in jeopardy. This time, Javon Smith. It's a 9-point lead for the Millers. Their largest lead of the game. Johnson getting a challenge here in the Twin Cities game. And all the fans in attendance, at least those on Washburn's side, loving the action. Cheerleaders certainly are. These Twin Cities games, always events. They bring so many members of the community on both sides of the river. Everybody wants to see the best basketball in the Twin Cities. The Twin Cities girls games always bring big crowds. And the Twin Cities boys games, no exception. Washburn with a 9-point lead. They're on a 10-0 run. But we've seen Johnson make runs of their own throughout the contest. This game not over yet. But their streak of victories against Minnesota teams is in jeopardy. Johnson winning their last 55 games against Minnesota teams. They have not lost to a team in this state for almost 2 years, to put things in perspective. And now they have to work once more to keep that streak alive. Johnson drops this. Washburn may become a sleeper in the Class 3A field if they get that far. Anthony Lee, in and out. That's been Johnson's story all game. Great shots, just not going in. But Marcus Marshall with the 15-footer, and he becomes the fourth Johnson player to break double digits. Only 3 have done so for Washburn, scoring more centric around a few players. But they have played balanced ball as well. Washburn calls timeout, full timeout, to get Jerry Pratt out of trouble. And so with 4:52 remaining, another dramatic pause. We'd like to remind you that following this game, we will have interviews with our players of the game for both teams. And then we'll bid adieu to the 2010-2011 regular season in high school basketball. Always a fun one. We had a lot of great games this year. Not a lot of blowouts. We saw a lot of action from the top teams in the state, including these two programs, Washburn and Johnson. What a game. And this would mean a lot to Washburn to take down the defending state champion in Class 3A and solidify their rebuilding phase. For Johnson, if they lose, they'll just regroup, reload, and go at it again in sections. They're not as strong a team as they were last year when they had Max Rosenblum leading the way. Pratt is padding his stats. I think he was padding his stats. Got a couple offensive boards. Washburn up by 9 again. And we're running out of time. 4:35 in half number 2. Lee in trouble. Finds Tyler. Tyler with the runner. And he draws a foul, which will stop the clock for Johnson. That works to their advantage, of course. Tyler with 8 points. Players in double figures for Johnson. Waylon Johnson with 14. Marshall, Scott, and Lee all have 10. Tyler, as we mentioned, the younger brother of Essence Tyler, who played on the girls' team for many years. Essence, now done with college, cheering on her little brother. And now Esten becomes the fifth governor in double figures. Thomas, fancy, but he can't get everything. And Roosevelt Scott draws a foul. Again, both teams in the penalty. Johnson doing exactly what they need to. Getting fouls, driving, and stopping the clock. Foul is on Shepard Anderson. The last one was on Shepard Anderson. That's his third. This one's on Dwight Anderson, and that's also his third. Roosevelt Scott now with 11 points. Again, Johnson scoring with the clock stopped. That's exactly what the governors want to do. Scott with a dozen. A 9-point lead is now 5. Dwight Anderson losing it, but kicks out to Nick, who will reset. Got an open paint, and the bank. Nick with 9 points. And Lee is fouled by Nick Anderson, and he knows it. And again, the clock stops. 3:49 left. The foul is Anderson's fourth, and he will step out for now. Washburn has the depth to absorb some of those fouls. Javon Smith and Cedric Chappelle, Washburn's biggest player today, are back on the floor. 1-1, Lee missed, and they give the rebound to Shepard Anderson. Johnson down by 7. And Dwight Anderson finding an open Chappelle and the back door. And that's killed Johnson today. The back door cuts. Now down by 9 again. And they'll be starting to feel some pressure. Johnson can't wait around too long now. Tyler for 3. Missed. That would have been big. Anthony Lee rips down a rebound. Smith Bond is fouled by Thomas. 3:06 remaining, and again, the clock will stop. But Johnson needs stops. Johnson in the double bonus now for the remainder of this game. They have ruled the foul on Chappelle. That is his fourth. Chappelle with 4. Anderson with 4. But you're getting to the stage in the game where you have to keep your best players in no matter how many fouls they have. And again, if Washburn does lose a player to fouling out, they do have reserves to back them up. Now they're going to look to eat up clock as they have a 7-point lead. Chappelle couldn't get the back door this time. And now Johnson on the run. Smith Bond losing it to Chappelle. Dwight Anderson back to Chappelle. That might do it. 22 points for Cedric Chappelle. He averages 12.5. Tyler out to Smith Bond. And another missed layup, and Smith Bond draws a foul. You have to imagine Vern Sibbins and the Governor's coaching staff will be looking at this tape and going over those short range shots. Johnson has not done well from short range today. 2:24 remaining. Miles Shepherd Anderson picks up his fourth foul. That makes three Millers with four. One thing's for sure, Chris Smith Bond has his free throw shooting figured out. We mentioned getting some Division III looks, and whoever picks him up is going to love his free throw shooting. You don't see that on a lot of post players. Chappelle was open again. Look out behind, and a foul is called. Roosevelt Scott snuck up from behind, stole it from Chappelle, and drew the foul. Foul is on Pratt, his third. And now if you're Reggie Perkins, you're going to be watching the foul numbers for each of your players as Johnson in the double bonus, of course, with 2:18 remaining. What a game. We don't have official free throw stats, at least not on me. But that's one asset that will help Johnson in big ways when the playoffs begin. They have now cut a 9-point lead to 5 again, but they're going to need some more stops. Dwight Anderson's open, and he draws a blocking foul. That's on Lee, his fourth. And that's Washburn's Achilles heel. As we mentioned, their free throws not going in. Johnson has the form. Washburn off today, and that could reel the margin back in. White makes the back end. He has 11, but it's still a two-possession game. Roosevelt Scott and Johnson finally with a drive and a basket at the most critical time. It's a 4-point game. Johnson slowly reeling in the Millers. They need stops, and they're being aggressive. 1:45 now. Dwight out to Thomas. He thought about it, but backs off. Washburn can eat up clock. Nick Anderson out to Pratt. Johnson not giving up the easy two, but they're not getting steals either. They need one. They need a stop. Anything to bring this in. Washburn will play Globetrotter ball as much as they want. That would have been a big basket from Thomas, but he's going to the line. They eat up 45 seconds of clock. And Johnson playing to prevent the layup. That went right into Washburn's hands, allowing them to pass the ball around and chew up time that way. They're not going to take a silly three. And a timeout is called, 1:15 to go. 75-70 the score. Washburn in position to take the win. An epic Twin Cities Boys Championship in what could be a state tournament preview in Class 3A. We should point out that if both Washburn and Johnson qualify, they will play at Williams Arena March 23rd for the quarterfinal. Following that, they will play at Target Center if they get that far. Too bad that I couldn't get a partner. Whoever would have called this game alongside me, I don't know who. It would have been a ball. But still a fun game regardless. Thomas, clutch. Johnson, in trouble now. Roosevelt, Scott. They'll give him as many layups as they want. As Johnson calls another timeout with 1:09 left. That time, Scott had to work a little harder to keep himself balanced, but he picks up another layup, and he is racking up the points quickly. He now has 18, leading all Johnson players. The game leader is Cedric Chappelle with 22. But if you're Reggie Perkins and Washburn, again, you'll give Johnson as many layups as they want, because that will not reel in the gap unless Johnson can get a steal. There's still time to do that, 1:09, but with no shot clock, even a one-point lead works to your disadvantage. Coach has talked about it for a while, and the notion of a shot clock was floated in the press a few years ago, but after the recession hit, that killed the idea for a while. Economy's slowly improving. I don't know if we'll see a discussion on whether or not to introduce a shot clock again. Some schools do use it. Some folks are against the idea because it would prevent upsets. Others are for it because it would stop teams from passing the ball around. As I pointed out, fans don't pay to see a game with players just passing the ball around for 2 minutes. They want to see who can hold under pressure. Shepard Anderson to inbound. And Roosevelt Scott fouls him. Both teams in the double bonus now. Roosevelt Scott fouled Clarence Thomas. Scott now has his fourth. The fouling will be key. As the time winds down. Thomas, not exactly the player you want to foul on Washburn. This is the back end. Still a two-possession lead, though. Johnson will be looking to make this a one-possession lead. And a foul on Washburn. 1:03 to go. With deep rosters, fouling will be a more used strategy as it becomes a game of chess with five players. Roosevelt Scott, fabulous second half. As we mentioned, will probably go to a Division I junior college, which is perfectly fine. That sets you up. for Division One traditional college. Getting a junior college gets you some playing time, gets you a chance to get that experience without a lot of pressure on your shoulders. Johnson going to play foul and chase here. As they believe Washburn doesn't have the free throw shooting to keep up with Johnson if it comes to a matter of foul and chase. Foul is on number four. We were not able to get his name. That free throw by Nick Anderson is big. That keeps it a two-possession game. Nick Anderson now the fourth Washburn player in double figures. This could be the longest 56 seconds of my career. Nick Anderson makes both. It's a 5-point game again. Washburn will give Johnson the lane. And another timeout called by Vern Simmons. Marcus Marshall with the basket. That gives him 12. While we're at this timeout, we'll recap the scoring for you quickly. Again, Johnson with five players in double figures. They are Roosevelt Scott with 16, Waylon Johnson with 14, Marcus Marshall with 12, Eston Tyler and Anthony Lee have 10. Washburn's four players in double figures are Cedric Chappelle. Chappelle the only one with 20 or more. Thomas with 18 points. Anderson, Dwight and Nick both have 11. As we take a time warp back to 1995. Barbie Girl not on the short list of tunes I would expect to hear in a basketball gym. And now we move a little bit forward in time. So we go from Barbie Girls to Dougie. Here's something I like to see on YouTube, a Barbie girl doing the Dougie. Wouldn't that be something? You can tell I'm bored and lonely. Not bored because of the game, but because I don't have a sidekick. And again, the game of foul and chase continues. Lee not happy, he knows he's done. Anthony Lee fouls out with 10 points. More substitutions are being made, of course. When a player fouls out, you're given 30 seconds to select a substitution. So almost a free timeout for the Governors, but Lee not happy, thinking I could have picked that up as he sends Dwight Anderson to the line, and he's been clutch. But he misses the front end again. Johnson going with this strategy because Washburn hasn't been as strong shooting free throws, and the Governors believe that's how they can win. Make it a battle of attrition from the free throw line. Dwight Anderson does get the back end, making it a two possession game, but now the lead is four. Marcus Marshall. Going to Tyler, now Washburn, playing a little tougher defense, but Tyler with the long two. It's a 2-point game now. And this time, Marcel West gets the foul. Called on him. That will send Dwight Anderson back to the charity stripe. West only with two. They may be looking to send Johnson players who don't have as many fouls on the floor, but they're going to keep sending that ball to Dwight Anderson. And Dwight Anderson, clutch from the line. He has 14. Out to Scott again. Scott with a tough layup as the clock continues to tick. 22 seconds. They give it to Dwight again. And Marcel West fouls him again. That's his third. 19 seconds remaining. Scott now with 22. 14 points have come in this half. And another timeout for Washburn with 19 seconds. Miller's content to give up the baseline drives, the drives in the paint, as they can trade two-pointers much easily, much more easily than three-pointers. Again, we will have interviews with our players of the game following the conclusion of this contest. And after this season ends, once all the state tournament events wrap up for winter, I may look into who else I can contact for sidekicks, for partners. So I'm not having to call games by myself anymore. I did that a few times in my career. This is the only time I've had to call a game solo in my career this year on a TSB television broadcast. Well, Dwight Anderson, who's been key, a clutch shooter in the final 56 seconds, continues to do so. He'll get player of the game honors. Johnson with possession again. Tyler feeding to Smith Bond. And Smith Bond just not finding it today. That will do it. The right idea from Tyler to Smith Bond, but Smith Bond just not the player who has found his stroke inside today. And that will likely seal this one. Fans are now heading out, including the Gopher women. They know this game is likely over. Even though it would still be a two possession game if Shepard Anderson makes these free throws, Johnson needed that basket to have a legitimate chance. Shepard Anderson does miss the front end. Washburn fans cheering. Shepard Anderson makes it back in. No time went off the clock as Thomas deflected the inbound pass. 9 seconds left. Johnson will have to get a ball off quick, but again, the clock does not stop even for a made basket. Won't matter. Washburn ends Johnson's streak against Minnesota teams. The 55-game winning streak is over. The Washburn Millers make a huge statement to end the season with an 85-80 victory. That Big Ten nothing run in the final minutes was the difference in this game.